thank you so much for coming. Thank you for being here tonight. If you're still coming in, we have a lot of seats in our upper bleachers. If you'd like to come on in and find a seat, you're welcome to do that. My name's Corinne Ormson. I'm the Fine and Performing Arts Specialist for the district, and I'm just so excited to welcome you here tonight. This is really exciting to be able to have this big event and welcome you all to Union High School. So we're really glad to be here. One of the things we're most excited to share with you tonight is the progression that you're going to see from elementary choir to middle school choir and then to high school choir. From all three of these groups, you will see the love and the excitement and the joy from students, but it's wonderful to hear the maturation of their voices as well as just the progression of the pieces that they sing. So I think that you'll really enjoy that tonight. I do want to recognize our elementary music teachers. Don't worry, the middle school and high school teachers will be recognized as well tonight. But since elementary singing first, we'll have our six elementary school teachers stand up. You can stand up now and then just wave to, as I say, your... So we have Bryn Scamahorn at Harmony. All right, so we're doing this. Okay, we've got Patrick Hensler at Illahee. We have Fauna Wolf at Columbia Valley. Boys and girls, we're not gonna stomp our feet. I know it's fun, we're not used. Thank you. Jennifer Velasquez at Emerald. Jordan Erickson at Pioneer. There you are. And last but not least, Amberlyn Lane over at the piano. She's at BBC. So I had the privilege to be at our rehearsal this morning with these elementary students from these six schools, and there was just so much joy and excitement as they worked together, as they came together. They came together as six groups, but left as one, and it was really, I think you're just going to really enjoy hearing them tonight. Before we start, we have a special guest with us who's going to say a few words. Please help me welcome Rob Perkins from the school board.
Thank you, Corinne. I am excited to be here as well. I really missed this during the years that we couldn't have this kind of performance, and part of that came from the fact that I performed in this choral festival as an elementary student, and then joined the band. So I didn't get to come to this, but I got to come to other things and was able to study music all the way from the fourth grade in elementary school all the way to senior in high school, participated. It was my happy thought coming to school. And Corinne wanted me to just share with you a story about that, I guess, is that experience, 10 years of experience studying music in these schools, as I graduated from Mountain View a long time ago, enabled me to keep making music whenever the opportunity came up, to the point that just this year I was able to join one of Portland's nonprofit choirs and participate with 100 people in singing Christmas music and those kinds of things. It's an audition thing too. It was kind of daunting to get in. And just to understand that kind of thing can be your kids' experience and your experience is something we really want to maintain. And in order to maintain it, we have to have the support of the community around us. And since we do, I'm here on behalf of the board to thank you all for that support and hope that we can walk up to the expectations and hopes that you have for your kids. Thank you.
And now please welcome your MC for the evening, Bryn Scamahorn.
Every year they give me a microphone. I try to talk them out of it. I don't know. We're going to start this evening. We're going to get rolling right away and get some singing happening for you. As you can see in your program, we're going to kind of do this in little steps. We'll have one song performed by the United Elementary Choir. Then we're going to have our United Middle School Choir, which is something really cool that I'm going to talk about here in a little bit. But first and foremost, we are going to have our elementary under the direction for this song of Miss Susanna Wolf, accompanied by Miss Amberlyn Lane on piano. And this is Amane Utupe. What a great little starting. What a great little opener there. So next we are going to have our United Middle School. And I say United, but this is not something that normally happens, but it's really, really cool that it is. This is the Frontier Choirs and the Pacific Choirs. And they have been rehearsing on their own. They came together early here today to practice. And this is under the direction of Jonathan Vaughn and Lily Kiyokawa and their accompanist Anna Grushevsky. Thank you.
Good evening. Thank you so much for coming. As been said, it's just it's an amazing event, and I really appreciate all of your support. A little bit about this first piece. It's a gospel arrangement of a piece entitled "How Can I Keep from Singing." It will feature some soloists, and if we would just ask that you save your applause till the end, and we will acknowledge those soloists. Again, this is "How Can I Keep from Singing."
Keep from
Awesome. Let's give another round for our soloists as well. Next is a little Latin piece for you. This is entitled Benedictus. A quick translation is Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he that comes in the name of the Lord. Benedictus.
Our final piece for the evening is called Ujednite se, which means stand united. It has text in English, Arabic, Bosnian, and Hebrew. So you will hear all of that in there. Also, a big shout out to Mr. Vaughn for being our drummer on this piece. This is a lot of fun, so we hope you enjoy Ujednite se.
When is the time to see?
right. So a little bit about what Mrs. Ormson was talking about at the beginning of the beginning of our concert, where we talked about the development, elementary to middle school, and we're going to do two more songs, but then you'll get to hear high school and that transition and how things work and how things grow. And I'm going to talk for just a second about the value of a music education. And most people who study music in school do not go on and be professional musicians. But as Mr. Perkins was talking about earlier, it has had an impact on his life that he has continued to perform and practice music. And it's become an integral part of him. My mother was also a musician, and she was a chef. But it made such an important impact on my life that I decided to do this with my life. And it's just one of those things that winds its way in you. But it also has been proven time and time again, studies, you can talk to any of your music teachers and they will share with you the information about how it develops the brain, how it helps impact the growth of the brain. It is one of the few subjects that we have where when we perform music, when we read music, when we study music, everything is going. It helps to build the dendrites between the two sides of the brain. So we are actually making ourselves smarter by studying music. And so all of those saying, why, it's just music, I'm not going to go, I'm not going to play later in life. You know what? One, makes you smarter, so do it, because it's great. Two, the joy that comes from it. And so it's a win-win situation. Joy, happiness, and you get your brain working, which is amazing. We are going to, I think we're just about there. We are going to transition back to our elementary schools at this point. But before we do, if you are in the audience, speaking of that transition, if you are in the audience, and this includes, I suppose, my middle schoolers, if you participated, and high schoolers, in music at any point in your school beyond elementary, would you please raise your hand? That is a lot of people. And as you look back and reflect on your time, I've had so many people come to me and say, I played tuba in band when I was in high school. I sang in my school choir. It's something that sticks with you. So thank you very much. Our next song is one of my absolute favorites. It is entitled The Dream Keeper by Rollo Dilworth, and it will be conducted. They like it too. It will be conducted this evening, I don't remember whom by. Oh, very good. Oh, there they are, Ms. Velasquez and Mr. Hensler. And we're accompanied again by Mrs. Lane, as well as we'd like to give a quick thank you to Mr. Zachary Sears, who is here playing bass with us on us. So thank you very much. And Mr. Erickson on our drums.
Thank you.
All right. Let me do this here real quickly. So I'm not going to say too much before the next one, except for I'm conducting the next one. And this is the Ray Charles song, Sir Duke. Oh my gosh, Stevie Wonder. Brain sometimes doesn't function right. Transition, which leaves me one more chance to talk into the microphone at you. At this point, I would like to thank some people. These sorts of programs and these educational experiences we have don't come together without a lot of different people. First of all, I would like to give a thank to principals and any administrators that are here tonight supporting your children. If you wouldn't mind standing up, giving a wave, thank you. Obviously, our school board and our upper administration who help keep us going find value in what we are doing as well. So thank you to Mr. Perkins and Mrs. Ormson as well for being here. I would like to thank parents. You do not get thanked enough. You get letters and you get told many different things, but you are also the ones that get your child to school. You are the ones that, in my case, get them there an hour before school starts in order to be there, even though they don't want to be there. For some, you're getting there to pick them up after school because the bus, there is no activity bus. When we get into middle and high school, it becomes a whole nother ball of wax, especially high school. There's so many more things and commitments and events and lessons and this and coaching sessions and sectionals and all sorts of things. And it could not happen without you. So I would like you, please, to give yourselves a round of applause. So thank you. And you can clap. My goal as a music educator is to have people who love music, who are not afraid to celebrate music in their lives until they're 80, 90, 100 years old. That is my goal. I want someone to be able to sing with their family. I want someone to be able to take a baby and rock it and sing them a lullaby. And I want someone to find joy and excitement in every type of music they hear, not just the music that they really, really like and identify with, but every kind of music. And I think you're seeing a great example of that here on this stage and in this gym tonight. So thank you very much for being here. I am now going to direct your attention over to Mr. Karn, and this is the Union High School Choir, and I will let him take it from there. Their accompanist is Laurie Collier.
Thank you very much. We got three quick songs for you. We'll start with Yonder Come Day. It is a traditional Georgia Sea Islands melody. And then we'll sing a traditional spiritual called Witness. And we'll end with Ad Astra. Part of it is sung in Latin. And it's taken from the Kansas state motto, which is through difficulties, through the stars.
Oh, day, yonder come day.
Oh, day yonder come day. Oh, day yonder come day.
Day unbroke in my soul, yonder come day.
Morning day
yonder come day.
Morning day yonder come day.
Morning day yonder come day.
Day unbroke in my soul,
yonder come day.
Brand new day
yonder come day.
Brand new day
yonder come day.
Brand new day
yonder come day.
Day unbroke in my soul.
Strongest man that ever lived on earth. When I gather in a
sense in strength was never found out. Says why sat upon his knees, she said,
tell me where your strength lies, if you please.
Well, old Samson's wife, she talked so fair, Samson said,
cut off of my hair.
Cut it off!
Leave my head just as clean as your hand, and my strength will come like a natural man.
Samson was a witness, oh my Lord. Samson was a witness, oh my Lord.
Gratitude to you. Thank you again for supporting. Thank you for coming out. We have one final song this evening that is all our choirs combined, so elementary all the way through high school, and it's always such a wonderful treat to hear them singing all together. There is one thing I want to talk about, elementary parents specifically. When we go to dismiss, I will call out names of schools, the teacher will raise their hand and move to a location. I normally have signs, but I forgot them today. That was my fault. And so we'll have them, but we're gonna ask that you send one representative up to grab your student. It only needs to be one, but it gets a little chaotic. So I just wanted to let you know that at this point, at the end, I will say out schools' names, the teacher will wave their hand, and the kids will congregate around that person. We wanna make sure everyone gets home with the right people safely. All right, so this is our final song this evening. This is our all combined choirs for the Eastside Choir Festival on Lift Every Voice.
Voice.